So dozens of new experiments being brought up to the International Space Station by the Cygnus cargo craft, one among them giving a very unique opportunity for astronauts to get involved in the classroom and give kids around the country a look at life on board the International Space Station. Joining me now, NASA astronaut and veteran space flyer, Alvin Drew. Alvin, first of all, thanks so much for joining me.
You're quite welcome. It's good to be talking to you today.
All right, and this experiment is called Storytime from Space. And I know you were very involved on getting this thing off the ground, literally, when it first kind of became an idea. Tell me about where the idea for this project came from and kind of what it entails.
Okay, well, I was preparing for STS-133 back in 2010. That was be the final flight of the space shuttle Discovery. And I was talking to a friend of mine, Patricia Tribe, who'd been the director of education over at Space Center Houston, about what a good time and what a rewarding experience it had been for me on STS-118 to be working with Barbara Morgan on the Teaching from Space program that she had. Patricia had the idea of reading story time, bedtime stories to kids from space, and asked me if I would be willing to go do a demo tape on board the space station during STS-133. And I was quite frankly a little surprised that we hadn't already done something like that. And that's usually my first indication that something's a good idea when I go, we aren't already doing that. And
yep.
So I was happy to oblige. We just need to go find a book that we could read.
Hi, I'm astronaut Alvin Drew aboard the Space Shuttle Discovery. I'd like to read you a bedtime story. This one is called Max Goes to the Moon by Jeffrey Bennett, illustrated by Alan Okamoto. This is a story of how Max the dog helped return people to the moon. This time to stay. It all began the morning of the parade. Max had just returned from his trip to the space station. He was a hero. After all, none of the astronauts could have come home safely without him. As Max's car drove down Pearl Street, Max looked to the west and began to howl just as the moon set over the mountains.
And what are some of the books that the crew are going to be reading and how are they chosen?
Okay, the book that it's been actually been written specifically for this particular payload was a story called Max the Dog Goes to the International Space Station. I was an author here in Boulder, Colorado, by the name of Jeffrey Bennett, who wrote a trilogy of books about his Rottweiler by the name of Max. He has an adventure where he goes to the moon. Later on, he goes out to Mars, and then he writes a final piece in there where one of Max's descendants goes out to Jupiter. And in the first book, the book I read was Max Goes to the Moon when I was on Discovery's mission to the space station. And I'd asked Jeff that in the beginning of the book, that it almost seems like a setup for a prequel where Max would go to the space station. And sure enough, a couple of years later, we got together and talked about what that prequel might consist of. And out of that came the story, Max Goes to the International Space Station, which will be the inaugural book read as part of Storytime from Space.
And again, this is going to be more than just the astronauts reading these books. They're going to be doing some of the demonstrations, too. What are some of the concepts that the crew are going to be demonstrating? What are they going to be working with to go along with the actual reading of these stories?
Okay. One of the things I liked best about Jeff Bennett's books was that there are these sidebars with the story. So you can either you can read the story to a three-year-old, and they would just enjoy the story of a dog going on adventures in space. But it's packed with a lot of scientific principles in there. Jeff Bennett, in his regular job, writes physics texts for universities. And so he's got this science tucked away in all these different corners of the story. And in these sidebars, if you want to get deeper into the science for older, more sophisticated children, you can talk about concepts dealing with space travel, things like being in microgravity, the feeling of being weightless, dealing with light and radiation in space. And so when we put this story time from space together, we decided we would take advantage of that as an opportunity for teachers to not only read these stories, but have demonstrations to go with lesson plans to teach some of those scientific principles to the students. So we have things like how do you weigh something in space, with using like a centrifuge. There's ones where we look at how you can use the sun's rays to create electricity and then look how things heat up separately, based on their colors up there in space. So why do we put things like foil on top of some of our satellites and make some surfaces white and some surfaces black? So we have experiments like that, and they're all put together by Canadian astronaut Bjarni Tryggvason, who's also a physics professor.
Okay. So really just kind of taking some of the And I mean, and it almost sounds some of the pretty complex aspects of spaceflight and just bringing it to a new audience, a much younger audience, kind of your next generation audience.
Yes. I mean, even though building rockets is rocket science, a lot of the physics behind it is not. And if it's demonstrated simply enough, they can grasp that and figure out what things they might want to go explore themselves.
And then obviously the plan, making this available to classrooms across the country, just widely available.
Yes, one of the things that the group putting together Storytime from Space has is a website that's under construction right now, and the plan is to take the video of the astronauts reading the books and putting that on the website for free download. Also, the demonstrations of these science experiments also be available, along with courseware and lesson plans and things like that that they can put together. So it's be able to have a powerful tool for teachers. To excite kids about that science, to get their imaginations going, and then to have experiments, things like, have some, put some rigor into that as well.
It sounds like a fantastic idea, a great way to get kids involved and excited about concepts and spaceflight and all these experiments. Again, the experiment called Storytime from Space, it'll be kicking off with this expedition. Alvin, thanks so much for calling in today. Really appreciate it.
You're welcome. Thanks for the opportunity to talk about Storytime from Space.
And that, again, a look at Storytime from Space, an experiment that just launched on Orbital One, arriving on board the International Space Station this past Sunday. To learn more, you can go to their website, currently under construction, but it'll have more information at storytimefromspace.com or also facebook.com/storytimefromspace.